Hello there, my name is the Default Guy, and I've decided to make some videos on Tycho mapping. These are mostly for people who have a basic understanding, if not already experienced with OSU standard mapping, but are interested in mapping Tycho. However, that's not to say that I'll completely disregard everyone else. That's not the point, as I will make other videos discussing different topics for each kind of person, whether you are someone that has no clue how the editor works for any game mode whatsoever, or you're like a professional Tycho player that knows what plays well and just wants to know how to map. I'll make sure to make a video addressing each one of those topics. Now, what the fuck is a Tycho? Tycho is one of the game modes in OSU inspired by the rhythm game series Taiko no Tatsujin created by Namco. In Taiko no Tatsujin, players simulate playing a taiko drum. That's what a taiko drum looks like. It's pretty cool. In sync with the music. Taiko is very different compared to the other game modes in OSU since it's almost pure rhythm. You don't have to aim like in OSU standard, move like in Catch the Beat, or play keys that are laid out horizontally like in Mania. You just have to worry about what keys are pressed and when. Think of it as a one-dimensional rhythm game where the only dimension you have to worry about is time. That would make OSU standard a three-dimensional rhythm game since you have to worry about time as well as the x-axis and the y-axis for your cursor, which would then make Beat Saber four-dimensional. Okay, this is a weird analogy. Now the first thing to talk about is the playfield. There's not much going on, but there are a few things that I think are important for you to know. Now this white circle here is called a judgment circle and it's used as a visual reference for when to play a note. Think of it as the Tycho equivalent to the approach circle. Here you have the HP bar, which indicates how much HP you have. I know, revolutionary. But the HP works a little different on Tycho than it does for the other game modes, but I'll talk about that slightly later in this video. Now the drum here is used as a visual representation of a taiko drum and indicates what keys you are pressing. Now this little black bar area thing, I'ma call it the conveyor belt. There's not really a official name, but it's just described as a conveyor belt in the OSU wiki, so I'ma call it that. This is where the notes will be passing by from right to left. Now to actually play Tycho, you use four keys. Now the default is Z, X, C, and V. These keys are used to play the Tycho drum. Now the Tycho drum is divided into two parts, the inner or middle part of the drum and the rim or outer part of the drum. To hit the rim of the drum, you would press either Z or V, and to hit the inner parts of the drum, you would press X or C. Now hit objects. In Tycho, there are four main types of hit objects. Regular notes, finishers, shakers, also known as spinners, and drum rolls, also known as sliders. First, we have the regular notes, and there are two kinds of them. There are blue notes, known as cats, and red notes, known as dons. It's important for you to know those names. To play these notes, you must hit the corresponding part of the Tycho drum. Dons are played by hitting the inside of the drum, and cats are played by hitting the rim of the drum. These notes make up the vast majority of hit objects in a Tycho map, as the other are used for certain scenarios and situations. In addition to regular notes, there are also finisher notes. Finisher notes can be red or blue, just like regular notes. However, they are played differently. Finisher notes are played by hitting the left and right side of the drum at the exact same time. Meaning that if you had a red finisher note, then you would press X and Z at the exact same time. If you have a blue finisher note, you press Z and V at the exact same time. Now, shakers or spinners are played by alternating between dons and cats, or cats and dons. It doesn't matter what order you choose, they just have to be alternating. Drum rolls, now these are a bit tricky to understand. They're played by hitting either the rim or the center of the drum continuously until the drum roll is over. It doesn't matter what you choose, in what pattern, what order, as long as you're, hitting something. The important thing to note, however, is that the amount of hits you can do in a single drumroll is hard capped and only counts when hitting the tiny hit circles in the center of, you know, the slider there. Now, how do you pass a map in Taiko? Now, this sounds like a stupid question, right? I mean, obviously, the goal is to play the right notes at the right time, and if you play the wrong note or slightly out of time, you get penalized for it, right? And if you play horribly, you fail, right? Well, no, not at all. You can actually get a lot, and I mean a lot, of misses and still be able to pass, but why? That's because of how health works in Taiko. In Taiko, you actually start off with no HP whatsoever and gain it by playing notes. If you play a note correctly, you gain HP, and if you don't, you lose HP. And at the end of the song, if your HP bar is at 50% or higher, then you pass. Because of this, there's a slightly annoying thing with Taiko, and it's that you don't fail until you reach the very end of the map. Now, one last thing you should know for now is that Taiko has its own naming scheme for difficulties, taken from Taiko no Tatsujin. The names for the difficulties and their equivalents in Osu Standard are Kantan, which would be easy, Futsu, which would be a normal, Muzukashi, which would be a hard, Oni, which would be an insane, Inner Oni, also known as Ura Oni, which would be an expert, and Hell Oni, which would be an expert plus. Now, each difficulty has its own rules and guidelines stated in the ranking criteria for Taiko that determines what makes, you know, a Kantan, a Futsu, and what differentiates an Inner Oni from an Oni. But that's a topic for another video, because there's a lot in the ranking criteria, like a lot. And that's it for the very basics of Taiko. It's important for you to know at the very least what the heck you're mapping for. And speaking of which, I highly recommend you at least play a bit of Taiko. Doesn't matter if you suck, just go ahead, download a Taiko beatmap pack and start playing some Kantans, maybe in some Futsus if you're a quick learner. Anywho, that's it for today. Thank you very much to the beautiful bastards whose names are on screen right now to help me make the script for this video, and I will see you in the next video.